Hey. Okay, I'm going to talk about contributing to Node.js. And if you've ever heard a talk about contributing to Node.js, there are a bunch of them out there, I'm going to assure you that this is nothing like that. There's a collaborator summit after this, a Code and Learn, that a lot of you signed up for, and that's kind of more on that end of getting into Node Core and contributing code there. So I won't have any coding. I actually personally try not to contribute to no core. I do contribute to Node.js, but in different ways. So here's the deal. In past years, it was pretty hard to get started with contributing to Node. The custodians kept the projects, pretty small to a small group of contributors. And I had tried at the time to contribute back then. I presented pull requests and issues, often spending hours putting them together and just have them closed in a day or even minutes. Sometimes I wouldn't even get a response. It wasn't very welcoming. But then IOJS came around, and along with many ES6 goodies, something, in my opinion, more valuable was pulled in, an open governance model. And the requirement that everything must be done in the open. They used GitHub for a lot of this, but they filled a major missing piece by hosting live meetings and even allowed Q&A live. And anyone was able to ask questions to the core team. They you know, followed up with trying to put an honest answer into answering those questions. This was the Node community I was looking for. But then the merge back with Node.js came along, and I was not thrilled. The meeting stopped, communication became scattered, and I couldn't tell what was going on. I disconnected. I was a little irritated, so. Then shy of just 1 year ago, I started getting spammed with YouTube notifications. Node.js just uploaded a video. Node.js just uploaded a video, one after another and after another. So finally, I'm like, okay, you know, what's going on over there? So I go to YouTube, and I find all these videos from this some event called Node Interactive. Like, I had never heard of it. So I go there, and one in particular caught my eye. It was actually the very first one posted. Convergence, evolving Node.js with open governance and an open community by James Snell. I'm like, okay, oh really? Here he is going on about how important open governance is, you know, that thing I saw disappear. So I checked out more, and this theme was used across many of the videos that I saw. And here's just a little bit of Denise.
And again, we're mostly interested in transparency. We're going to ask you to hold us accountable for that. You can't find out how it's happening. Ask us.
You should be able to find our minutes from our board meetings. You should be able to find the statement about where the next board meeting is happening. They happen virtually, so you can join too. You should be able to find pretty much everything. And if you can't, you should definitely let us know, because transparency is one of the secret sauces of open source, and we have to work hard to maintain that transparency.
Oh, really? So where do my meetings go then? SoundCloud. It turns out they stopped using YouTube and they went to SoundCloud. I just didn't get the memo. But there was a new problem for me. All of that she just said about the minutes, the open board meetings, and the agendas all being online, that was not true. They were nowhere to be found. They were not online. The meetings were not broadcast. And there certainly was not a dial-in for people. All right, so let's reach out, like she said. So I sent a Twitter message. She said, contact me on Twitter. Contact her on Twitter. No response. I also went and opened up a bunch of issues on GitHub. this is only a partial list, and this is the TSC repo only. But what about those board minutes? I posted a few weeks later, and nothing. Till 2 days later. Hey, Michael, can you give some pointers? But then silence again. Didn't hear back. Let's have faith. You know, let's try again. I'm still looking for those minutes, and then where are they at? And then finally, boom, Michael sent a text back. You know, I'll send them when I land in Paris. A little later that day, the email came in with the board minutes attached. So you know what this means now? The ball is in my court. I have the solution to the problem. It wasn't that I didn't have the minutes. It was that they were not published online. So immediately, I opened a PR. It was reviewed and merged in minutes. So why? Why go to all this trouble for board minutes? Like,
I think we, in general, are doing a pretty terrible job of bringing outsiders along on the same journey that we're on. But at the TSC level, we've got significant amount of churn, and we are even having trouble with ourselves keeping up with it all, and we're certainly not bringing on outsiders with it. So we need to do better. It's a failing, and it's not a good one.
The topic of openness and transparency shouldn't be assumed to be about protecting from nefarious activities. Denise actually believed that the information was being made available online. Later, I discovered, as I suspected, that to her, the idea that it wasn't online was absurd. So what happened? Well, it was simple. Nobody volunteered to do it. Well, until I did. I want us to try to document as much as we can for you. I don't want to neglect the parts of the story because they're boring or not page-turning chapters. I don't want to risk falling into an editorialized recollection of the history, even if nobody intended to do so. Documenting the work we do on Node.js and the discussions that brought us to where we are today is so anyone of any background can follow along, get informed, and join in as if they had taken the journey with us. And by the way, that audio of Rod was him answering a question I asked during live Q&A during one of the TSC meetings. I reflected on that answer for a few days, and eventually I realized where I could bring the most value to the Node community. It was here. This is what they were asking for at last year's Node Interactive. Help raise topics, start the conversations, extract information into issues and PRs. These are really important ways to help out. And I've already been doing it for months. The Technical Steering Committee Charter begins with Section 1, Guiding Principle. The Node Foundation will operate transparently, openly, collaboratively, and ethically. Project proposals, timelines, and statuses must not be merely open, but also easily visible to outsiders. This isn't just some like it sounds good thing that was jotted down. This is what it takes to make sure that anyone from any background can find their way into the community. And we need more people to help show up, to show up and help, I mean. Producing new versions of Node.js takes a big team of contributors now. It's a big machine with many moving parts, needing many people of different skills and backgrounds. So, like any large group of people, it needs coordination. So there is this foundation. Most people have no idea what that means. Like, is it a bunch of people that get together, like a Bible study, or, you know, a secret handshake society, you know, amongst a few big companies? No. The answer's on the website. If we peek at this certificate of incorporation document, we see that it was formed in August of last year. It was in the state of Delaware. It has a board of directors, and it's a 501c6, which is a type of nonprofit that serves its membership. That's you, or it could be you. If we pop over to this document, the bylaws, it says a bunch more information. Most notably to our interests is that there must be a technical steering committee that is in charge of the technical direction of the project and that there are members. That's you, or it could be you. For more information on how to become a member, click here or in the comments below. It's a 20-minute talk. I had to cut something out. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Right now, Laura's like in the back or something, like, oh, seriously, William? Like, okay, add link to video and in comments. Yes. Speaking of the Linux Foundation, this is a relationship. It's one of the most confusing things about the Node Foundation. Why? Yes, that's right, because it's not documented and easily visible to outsiders. Let's help fix that right now. It's very simple. The Node.js Foundation pays the Linux Foundation for consulting services, and by having this arrangement, the Node.js Foundation is therefore a Linux Foundation collaboration project. So the Linux Foundation is like your homeowners association's management company, but for open source projects. All right, this is how the org is set up. There we have the technical steering committee, as mentioned before. We have some big black boxes over there. Just want to illustrate them as big black boxes. So the technical steering committee deals with the administrative details of the foundation. This is where I'm often buzzing around it. The real technical work is dedicated to the CTC, the Core Technical Committee, which then delegates many things to working groups, teams, and collaborators. That's you, or it could be you. You might think the board belongs at the top of this diagram, but that doesn't really feel representative of how things really work. The collaborators are at the top. They make the substantial technical decisions. The groups below, they serve to support the groups above it. And I can't comment about the black boxes over there. OK, all of this stuff is important just to give you context of the world Node lives in. That stuff will help you decipher some of the discussions you'll come across in the Node.js GitHub repos. So let's talk about GitHub. The Node.js GitHub org is one of the most active open source orgs on GitHub. That's because we use GitHub for almost everything. So you'll need to understand how we use GitHub. Obviously, yes, we use it for code projects. But as mentioned before, there are several working groups, teams, and the CTC, the TSC. Each one of them has a repo that is used to collaborate on, for their topic. These repos usually won't even have code in it. This one just has a few documents in it. The repo exists just for the issue tracker. So if you look over there, you will find where all the action is. All right, but working groups, there's a page on the website listing them all. So you can go there and check out what each one is for. You can also click on the link and pop over to GitHub and dig in even more. Teams, on the other hand, they're harder to find and understand. They are informal groups that have been created to kick off looking into something. They're, like, recently we created the group for looking into creating an official Node version manager. Pretty cool. There isn't an easy way to discover them right now, and that's one of my big criticisms. There are just a few teams. There are a few teams I'd like to call out. There are a few teams that like to call themselves working groups, just to add to your confusion. Just know that if you can't find them on the working groups page, then they're not chartered and they're not an official working group. So let's say you dive into the documentation working group and you read up on what they're doing and what they want to be doing, maybe, in some cases, and you make some suggestions, hopefully open some PRs, then what? Notifications. Notifications are a major key to getting involved and staying up to date. You may not hear back for a while on your issues, so click the watch button, and you'll get an email like every time something happens on that repo. This notification system is a big reason why we use GitHub to collaborate. Here's a pro tip. For the folks over at GitHub, they use the special emails. When the emails come in that you've, like for in this case, been mentioned in. So you can put filters on them and set them up. Big warning, the Node core repo has a lot of notifications. There's a lot of activities there. So many of us have filters set up on it. So we only get notified when we're mentioned directly in a comment. Furthermore, we all know that we do this, so that's why you'll see people at mentioned in comments. Contributing takes major patience and major diligence. I'm going to leave you with a few of my top tips for interacting on GitHub. Number one, don't assume you're right. Do your homework, show what led you to your current point of view. If you're wrong, someone will come along, add some missing piece of information, and then it'll be documented for the next person. Don't just open issues. Research possible solutions and say that you're willing to help. This one's a big one. Your work will be scrutinized. You need to get to a state of mind where you're okay with that. Don't get offended. The person isn't after you. They don't think they're better than you. If you look at that person's work, you'll find that somebody is scrutinizing the work that they're doing. That's how the system works. It's like that because everybody just wants to build the best product possible. Once you get on board with that way of life, you'll switch your mind and then you'll just expect it. It'll be no big deal. Patience. Node is a worldwide community. So a lot of times you need to wait for people to wake up or get off work, or a lot of times it's just for whenever they get a minute to go check their email. When I sent those messages, those tweets to Denise, I didn't expect her to drop everything she was doing and go make it right. The reality is that she doesn't need to answer my questions at all. No one needs to help us. Everyone is a volunteer. In general, people want to help you, but in no scenario does someone want to work for you. So don't be bossy. You must champion your own cause. Be persistent. Where are those board minutes? There isn't a board member I have met that hasn't had to hear me go on and on about how we're not getting the board minutes and we're not getting enough notification for when board meetings are going to be announced. And now I'm here barking at you even more about it. All right, so all of this is how contributing to Node happens today. This is the outcome of a bunch of volunteers' best efforts. It is not perfect. It is not optimal or even correct. So this talk is a PR to you, the community. With all the background information of what led me to this point of view, my suggestions on how I think we can make it better, and my best efforts to help out. Please send me some LGTMs and some NITs. My name is William Kapke. Thank you.